In 2014, when Dr. Poonam Khetrapal Singh took over as Regional Director of WHO's Southeast Asia region, she identified 7 flagship priority areas of work that reflected the region's public health needs and challenges and which needed to be addressed on a priority. Eliminating measles, which is a major childhood killer disease, and controlling rubella, a major contributor to irreversible birth defects. Reducing maternal, under 5 and neonatal mortality with a focus on reducing neonatal deaths. Fortifying emergency risk management as the region is prone to natural disasters. Combating antimicrobial resistance, a major public health challenge that threatens to make antibiotics ineffective. Finishing off key neglected tropical diseases, which continue to affect the people often left out of health services. Advancing universal health coverage to ensure that every person gets the needed health care without financial hardship. Reversing the non-communicable disease epidemic to arrest and reverse the growing number of cases of diabetes and heart diseases, which cause preventable deaths. Ending tuberculosis was added as the 8th flagship in March 2017 to accelerate progress against this pressing public health threat.
My vision is to partner with all member states in eliminating gross health inequalities and promoting well-being of all at all ages. My vision is to augment the capacities of all member states so that our region is recognized for its intellectual vigor and evidence-based decision-making. I'm determined to make WHO Southeast Asia a region which pursues excellence and is both responsive and accountable. My vision is to make our region globally known as a leader in public health.
The vision, commitment and the drive for results with the focus on priority programs is positively impacting health and lives of 1.8 billion people across the region. Between 1990 and 2015, maternal mortality declined by 69%, under 5 child mortality declined by 64%, and neonatal mortality has reduced by 54%. For fortifying emergency risk management, countries are conducting periodic assessments of capacities to prevent, detect, and respond to outbreaks and emergencies. The improved preparedness was instrumental in minimizing death and damage during the 2015 Nepal earthquake. CRF, the Southeast Asia Regional Health Emergency Fund, was set up in the aftermath of the 2004 tsunamis to provide immediate financial help to countries for their emergency response. CRF has funded 33 emergencies and disbursed $5.1 million as immediate funds. The CRF mandate was expanded in 2016 to include preparedness in addition to response. For advancing universal health coverage as a platform for achieving SDG 3, all countries are now gathering more and better information on health services coverage and financial protection. All countries are implementing national strategies to enhance human resources for health. And recently, in 2016, the Southeast Asia Regulatory Network was created to increase access to essential medicines. For reversing the non-communicable disease epidemic, all countries have committed to 25% relative reduction in overall NCD mortality by 2025 and are taking initiatives to achieve this goal. Towards combating antimicrobial resistance, all countries are implementing their multi-sectoral national action plans. The region was certified polio-free on 27th of March 2014. It not only maintains this status, but also leads in polio transition with program assets now supporting broader public health goals. In 2016, the region achieved maternal, neonatal tetanus elimination and is now working to maintain this status. There has been substantial reduction in malaria cases and deaths across the region. Maldives in 2015 and Sri Lanka in 2016 were certified for malaria elimination. In 2016, Thailand became the first country in Asia Pacific and the second in the world to eliminate mother-to-child transmission of HIV and syphilis. Major advances have been made in the efforts to end neglected tropical diseases. India was verified for yours elimination in 2016. Maldives and Sri Lanka were validated for lymphatic filariasis elimination in 2016. The region is making rapid progress against vaccine-preventable diseases. Earlier in 2017, Bhutan and Maldives have both been verified for measles elimination. The most recent achievement is that of Thailand, which has been verified for lymphatic filariasis elimination in 2017. Together, we are moving from vision to results and advancing health for billions in the Southeast Asia region.